Oh, it's the Harith, Manjin.
Oh, no. It's the Harith.
And the Kufra.
It's the Indonesian Harith, man.
The tides have changed. Harith is open, up for the taking. The Masha banned out by RRQ. They respect it themselves.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, I like the respect. I like the respect, bro.
It's all about respect.
It's all about respect.
Okay, imagine, you know what?
Whoa!
Malaysia with the back shot.
Malaysia with the back shot, you can call it. My back shot, I don't know. I'm trying to put something there, but okay. It's in.
I can't think of a word for you right now.
Oh, Chango. Again. Okay.
Don't fix what's not broken. Chango in the back shot, let's go. The cover fire strategy.
What is the
answer for RRQ? RRQ needs to find something out to kind of counter this.
Look at the Chango peace sign right there, man.
Peace.
Look at the Chango peace sign.
Is this a selfie from the Chango?
That is a selfie from the Chango.
That's a selfie,
that
right?
That is a selfie from the Chango,
the selfie
man.
Post.
The selfie post.
Oh, wow.
That is, of course, the Malaysian selfie, but look at this. They picked out another Valir for the side of RRQ.
Toadek banned this out, I think, back-to-back games for game number 2 and 3. And Toadek was, evidently they won. And maybe they know, they respect so well how Valir can work for RRQ. And the way you play the Valir is just to try it, just to have impact throughout all the stage of the game, right? Because level 1 with the Valir, as a core, you can kill. But level 1 as a Valir, as a support, just get another tank or maybe another core and you'll get the kills.
Yes.
That is the early game. Mid game, you have so much potential because of your pushback, because of your stuns.
Yeah.
And late game, you have percent-based damage. So if you think about it, Valir, it's like a Swiss knife.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. It can transition into a core hero in the late game. But man, look at this. RRQ really having a hard time in picking something right here. Are they not prepared for the backshot pick?
I don't know, but
we don't know.
At least they can push back the back shell when it does, you know, initiate. They might be tempted to get the Granger once again just to have a way to reach through the Chang'o, but you know what? The idea of you trying to match the range of the Chang'o with the Granger is actually not that effective. I think the right approach to a Chang'o is look for someone to dive the back lines.
Yes.
So RRQ, I think that they will last pick maybe another Hellcurt work, perhaps.
Or a
Gushin. But I'm not entirely sure.
Or a Gushin. But Gushin is bad here, man, against the X-Borg and against the Baksha. They need an assassin.
They need an assassin
they need
for
an
sure.
Assassin.
The Thams is there. I like it because you can use the Thams as your frontliner to kind of tank the Meteor Shower.
Yes.
Get the Quadrant Inferno, get the Blade Mail.
Yes.
So that you can kind of deal with your against your opponent.
Plus it's an answer to the fire sticks of the X-Borg, the pullback mechanic from the site. Let's see now.
Rafaela and the Cho.
The angel is here.
The angel.
Is this the guardian angel?
RRQ with the Bruno.
RRQ with the Bruno. Is this the Indonesian football, man?
Oh, wow. Okay, so here's the thing, Manji. Toadek picked up the Rafaela because they know that they have to kind of speed things up.
The speed boost
with the back shot, that's actually really scary.
Yes.
Even with the last Insanity paired up with it. All of the members of Team Toadek, they get something out of this speed boost from the Rafaela.
Definitely.
For sure the healing is there, but I think the speed boost merits a lot of
Indonesia smash proving that they are
all troops
the
deployed.
Best in the world. RRQ, they are still in the red side. Bin as the Valir, Sin as the Harith, Liam as the Kufra, Tuturo as the Thams right now, and Lemon will be playing the Bruno.
Toadek on the blue side, X-Ray the X-Factor with the X-Borg. That is Moon on the Chang'o. Triple X is Eon on this Baksha. That's Chiku on this Cho. And Nenas on the Rafaela.
Okay, I'm excited for this one. Rafaela having the Avarice, giving him extra gold right here. But man, the plan
for
Toadek is to get another statue shocker in the early game. Look at this 4-1 rotation. Immediately in the top lane, man. There you go. That is the start from Eno. All of them are level 1. That is a 4 guard for you. Team Toadek going back getting all of the objectives.
So very early lead coming up from Team Toadak, but just like in the previous game, there's the magic in RRQ that they still even up in terms of the gold, even when they are losing some parts of their jungle. Yes. Now they want to force out Lemon. Lemon doesn't know this. And Lemon. Oh no, where's Lemon?
Lemon, okay. Okay. He has the dash.
He has the dash.
He will be alive. Liam and company, they want to defend this. They want to get their own crab coin.
Definitely.
Meanwhile, Totoroi just having the time of his life in the bottom lane, getting all the grammars, getting all the gargoyles, and his own crab coin as well. Unfortunately for Team Toadak, the turtle will spawn in the bottom side. So that's why Sid and Totoro are here. They will set it up.
This is interesting, Magic, because instead of focusing on the Harith, they actually pummel down all of their resources against the Bruno
against
on this early
Bruno.
Game. I'm not entirely sure if that's the best case scenario, because I still believe that Harith is such a good hero that you should be contesting at all costs.
Yes,
but
course.
Then again, Toadak will have to decide. They can only pressure one hero at a time. Is it going to be the Bruno or the Harith? This time they decided it's the Bruno.
I think it's a 50-50 matchup for the Chango and the Harith, man. Let's see, the Harith can just dive in the Chango, but the Chango can the Harith is an easy target for the Chango, especially if the Harith lands the Zaman Force. It's like your target practicing with the Midger Shower. You have guidelines, but as I say this, Totoro will defend the mid lane. There you go, Last Insanity is falling low.
They're falling low indeed. They have dove too deeply, but they will not be punished this time. The speed was
first.
However,
blood.
Rafaela found by Liam as well as a Sin.
First blood.
And this is another deadly Sin, Manjin.
Yes.
That is Harith. I think Liam was seen after. Now, Lemon, just wait. You know what? This is the problem with Bruno, right?
Yeah.
Give him a little bit of an inch, he's gonna turn it into a mile.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
Nice
just
ultimate,
practicing
by the way.
His football skills in the top lane and creating pressure in the side lane. That was clearly a failed attempt for Team Toadak to get the first mid-tier tower. Because what's interesting right now is that even though Toadak, they got all of the first round buffs, but still RRQ, they're leading by 1,000 and defending all of their base. There you go, there's another class, there's Simon Force. Four-man stun coming in from Team Toadak. There's a meteor shower, but this damage enough. Totoro will fall. Last Insanity coming in for Mr. X-Ray. The Lemon is here. He is at half health. Liam is just doing some stretch, and then there's another rollout coming in from Eno.
They will not push through with this. This is not advisable for Team Toadak. They will should be happy with the kill on Totoro at this point. Now, onto the middle.
Oh.
X-Ray, no. Sin finds the Zaman Force committed. There's the stun. Of course, the knock of the ultimate as well. Healing coming up from the Rafaela is not going to be enough.
Yes.
RRQ finds two.
Now, Sin. Sin is like, hey, I played the side lane earlier. Can you give
Turtles
me the core? Can you give me the mid lane? Can you give me the Harith?
No.
I will go for the acrobatic place and I will do some moves.
That's the problem, right? If you give a little bit of a breathing space for the Harith, he's gonna get into Calamity Reaper zone as soon as possible.
Yes.
And that is scary. The Pillager Ask acts in there as well. By the way, the additional slow from the Pillager Ask is actually so much value.
It's so good, plus the extra 50 true damage from this Azure Blade. And man, Sin is on a roll right now. 737 magic damage. Here comes another rumble. Here in the jungle, that is a rollout for the turtle will join the fight. Nanas will just turn around and just heal his allies with the Holy Blessing. Toadak going for the disengage.
Good control from Toadak. They survived that one, but they have to defend this turtle. How can they defend? Sin is here.
How?
The damage is palpable.
Okay.
They will slay the turtle this time, Magine. And
okay.
Sin, he wants to fight.
Another Zaman Force, ladies and gentlemen, but the meteor shower is there. But man, Chrono dashing in. Chrono dashing out. It's like Allen Iverson, man. Sin.
The crossover
Harith is here, and they will push this mid-tier tower. Oh no, another stun.
This is really what you want to do against the export. Do not fight with the export.
Oh no, he knows this.
No more Piranha Armor for you. Oh, Sin. So deadly. There is going to be the way of the dragon, though. The punish is real. The shutdown. Toadak. And look at this.
Roll out.
Very, very speedy Baksha. Oh wow, that's scary.
Doesn't want to go for a re-engage. But unfortunately for Sin, he's just way too good. Diving into the mid tower. They did not expect Siku to be there. That is indeed a shutdown for Team Todak. Will that give them gold to get back to this deficit? Sin is still winning here.
Oh, that stun though. Basha, look at how much damage they have in the valley. Bruno, but of course the Wave of the Dragons gonna be able to take out the Bruno. The speed boost and the courage pass.
Okay.
They're safe.
Okay.
Wow.
Wow. Okay, it's Siku right now. Siku is the X factor right now for Team Todak, but my eyes are all in Sin. Look at this man. He is at level 9 with the Impure Rage. Still, he can go for tower dives like this. That is the finger coming in from Moon. The Holy Blessing will save his life. Here comes the last Insanity. Totoro with the jump out to safety. Sin is still safe again, dodging all the fire snakes.
Wow. It's really scary as Team Todak and RRQ, they're trading blows. No one dying at that moment, but RRQ, they still kept the better of the trades because they have 4,000 ahead of Todak. They have 3 turrets taken out, and already no turrets taken out by Todak. That's actually not that good.
That's
the Malaysian crowd.
That is of course very sad for them, because we are now at 7 minutes. Their plan was to get the mid tower at around 4 minutes, but Sin, he got all of this scrap coin and all of these experience to give him the opportunity to get the power spike. That is of course a way of the dragon. There's coming another flash, and Sin, he loves this fight.
Sin
is a narrow face. Sin, he is coming here to win, but X-Ray is just Luzan giving the Miraga armor. He is still inside the Diamond Force. Go for the Kono's Ash. He's at half health, but man, Sin, dude, again, surviving.
Surviving indeed. Top lane turn. Oh, actually, that's the bottom lane. Destroyed by the Chang'e. RRQ are overstaying in here, but already the Harith is in the mid lane. They want to go for the Force.
They're
on the turret. And that is the Zaman Force committed to the guild. While Moon on the bottom side with the cannon to help him out.
Yes.
Was able to take the trades.
Moon believing, and looking at the Moon. 5-7 is the score. Bruno will defend the bottom side. RRQ, they get nothing but the tower. They're hoping for a pickup, but Todak is just too tanky. Eno palming that ultimate, but man,
Bruno,
oh, okay.
A solo kill? Okay, but it will be punished. There's the pushback. Oh, the rebound is not enough though.
Who is better than kicking? Who is better than kicking?
Iron Legs or the Joe?
Who is better in kicking, I mean, yes.
Let's see. But the pushback is there. What a nice counter action from Finn. They take out the export. They've got the additional kill to Rafaela this time. The slows and the pushes. Even the backsha. The stun is real.
My,
but
the
roll out.
Real.
Oh,
the damage.
What
oh,
the play from
the
Liam.
Block. The block, man.
Block by Liam.
Totoro coming in with the first damage. Siku once again going for another stun. But okay, this is it. RRQ, ladies and gentlemen. They have the advantage. They're leading with a huge margin. Sin at 6-1-1, level 12. Lemon going in for a one-on-one with a Chang'e. They're so confident right now coming into this Lord.
This is scary. This is a full 5v5 flash if ever. But no, the Cho is up top, so this is a 4v5 if ever. Valor is coming into the fray. Manjin, what's gonna happen in here?
I don't know. There's going to be a clash. There you go. That is the stun coming in for Mr. Eno. That is, of course, the turret destroyed in the top lane. Who will get the turtle in? It's Sin. Sin again. X-I double N.
Sin sanity, Manjin.
Sin.
We are here with RRQ's Sin. Giving us a lot of plays.
This is it. Sin Sanity from Indonesia. You can actually call him Sindonesia, because he is representing his country.
Represent.
Represent. Sindonesia is alive. Sin Sanity, raise your hands. 6-9, 10 minutes with the Feather of Heaven and of course a concentrated energy. This Harith is just too real of a deal.
Ooh, RRQ, they're forcing it. Minion wave will not be cleared by the meteor shower. They jump it forward, Manjin. They have the Zaman Force of Sin.
The tower will fall down. No, it won't. That is the defense coming in from Team Todak. RRQ backing off. Ooh. Team Abin is now just poking them, but look at the cut.
Look at the cut. From the Cho. Very nicely done. So that RRQ will not continue this.
he's controlling the minion waves, controlling the minion equilibrium.
Oh yeah, so even with the Lord on their side, they only are able to... Oh, Zed actually snatches an inhibitor in the mid lane.
Oh no.
I was about to say that they weren't able to take in the turret, but Zed says, nah, I'm gonna change. This is insanity.
Nah, this is insanity. I was using Hellcurt earlier. It's very different with the Harith. You can't kill me now.
I can play mage, man.
I can play mage, dude. That's how good I am. And right now, Team Dodak, they're praying for their lives. The tower is gone, and they cannot even reach the Bruno. Bruno is at his maximum potential, even though with more deaths, he has the bounty hunter to regain this type of power spike.
Yeah, exactly. With a bounty hunter, just with the kills, he can kind of get back to recovering in terms of farm.
Yes.
But it's no longer about that, man, Gene. All of the heroes now of RRQ, they reached their potential already. This is 12 minutes. They have very strong team fight right now, and they can definitely fight against Dodak. But Dodak, you have to give it to them. Their defense is so good. They have the Rafaela to sustain themselves. They have Export for the wave clear. They have the Chango, even better wave clear through this meteor shower. Look at that.
Oh,
just
my.
Using the meteor shower so that the minions will be cleared.
I like it.
And RRQ, even with their strength, they cannot push without minions.
This is the Malaysian defense, man. It's like the Kuala Lumpur between Petronas Twin Towers, standing tall, 13 minutes in. What kind of initiation can RRQ do?
Ooh, nice steal from Sin. Just a chrono dash and a little bit of nudge. And took it to the face.
With the help of the Impure Rage. Oh no, oh!
What a dodge!
What a dodge, but okay! Siku coming back! Is there enough damage?
No!
There isn't!
That is really tough break for Team Todak as they lose their Cho. A very important, a vital cog in their composition. And it is also a hero that can get out of the map and maybe cut the minion waves. But without him, that's going to be really hard for Team Todak right now.
Yes, definitely. And I like the flicker out from
the Bruno.
Oh my. RRQ still.
Lord resurrecting
they're
soon.
Still in this one. Team Todak. The announcer said that the Lord is resurrecting soon. There you go. That is the Lord. Here we go. Oni.
Damage! Oh, it hurts!
The damage, it hurts, man! The fires! The flames!
Force out the poisons, the ultimate from the Baksha. This means the Team Todak will have the integrity of their team fight reduced by so much. And so, this means that RRQ can just freely take this Lord. There's just no way for Todak to enter. And it's Lord number two in favor of RRQ.
Yes. One last push coming here for Team RRQ. That is, of course, the Tyrant Sage. Here comes the Holy Blade. Sim going for another Zaman for the Chrono Dash. That is the Baksha going down. Chrono Dash in his Sin. And Thunder is falling down as well. X-Ray is falling low. No more Miracle Armor. Two heroes falling down. Lemon is at full health. And Barry is now looking strong to end the game. 36 seconds left on the dead timers. Look at the minimap.
The Cho is not there, man.
The Cho is not there.
Oh, Rafaela getting caught on Chiku.
Okay.
So we're saying that's going to be a kill on the Harith.
This is the heart.
An off-gun kill.
This is the heart. They're playing with their hearts out.
They're playing with their hearts out, man. Chiku needs to run away. Needs to run away from the members of Todak.
Oh! Liam with a clutch cancel.
The cancel. Oh, Liam. Oh no, this beast and the Chango, the Baksha, they will be the only ones. My goodness. Can they defend against this Lord? Looks like they can. Looks like they can.
The Lord has fallen. The Lord has fallen. Lemon is here. That is killing spree from the Bruno. Siku still playing around with the Kubra. RRQ, Team Indonesia. They want to do this. The minions are here. That is double kill coming from Lemon. Plus he has immortality.
Lemon.
Bruno, Lemon. Lemon is on the floor. Lemon is on the floor. Throw in the towel.
They want to win.
And of course, they proved that Indonesia is the best in playing Mobile Legends.
On to the finals, Manji. RRQ, the amazing control of the map all throughout the game.